Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Beacon from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a one-stroke bird. And when I say bird, I mean the bird that flies, not the female bird, like, because people call women birds. Here's my, it's like my bird. Yeah, in England, people call their other half, their better half, their bird. This is one of them birds. So we're going to use this blue, this green, this one's the pearly range, and then we've got from the glitter range we have this colour, and then from the shimmer range we have this colour. So with the blue, we're going to do a fade. So we're going to do the blue at the top. What I'm going to do first is just one coat. I'm going to use the brush to fan it down. Now this brush we previously made in a video. It just helps you to blend. So that's all I'm doing at the minute. Then I will put a second coat on. Pop that in the lap. So second coat. Get it nice and neat. So with the green, I paint the tip first. Take the brush. And start to blend. Do two coats of that. Next colour is this one, which is the shimmery colour. We just want one coat of this. And it's just going to make it all nice and shimmery. Before I cure that, I'm going to add some of this glitter towards the bottom, just to make it extra sparkly. And pop that in the lamp. Right, so I'm going to use some polycolours. So I've got white, this is titanium white. There are a few different whites, but titanium white is my favourite. And we've got Nero Black. This is black. It's just. And then we've got burnt umber. What's an umber? I know what an umberdinger is.
Sure, you made that joke last time we used this.
Did I? Sorry. Right, so we're going to load this brush. One side's going to have the burnt umberdinger on. The other side's going to have the white on. And you want to blend it until you get a soft blend. Like that. But before I do that, I might have made a mistake. I don't want to paint directly onto this. I have to buff it. Working onto a matte surface is better. A buffed surface is definitely needed for this. I'm going to start by doing some feathers here. Then we're going to do longer feathers here. Longer and bigger feathers. Literally placing it on and dragging. Look at the angle of my brush. It's super, super important. You're going to work round into smaller. So you're going to go from long to smaller. What I'm going to do is go over these again to give them more depth. I want these to look like they are slightly closer than these ones. So you want them a bit brighter. See how they're a bit softer? You want to keep reloading your brush to make sure you've got enough wet paint on your brush. We're going to go tap. So we're doing little taps because those are the little tiny feathers. From here, we're going to come round. So I'm using it quite wide now. We're going to do the valley. Before you ask, I have no idea what type of bird this is. It's just a bird in flight. Just going to do the basic shape of the head. The rest of it will be done with a normal brush, just doing normal hand painting. So you're going to get the majority of it done with the one stroke technique and then add extra detail with just normal hand painting. Detailing brush, I'm going to use black. So I'm just going to edge the head here. We're going to add some detail, like the little markings these are. And people are going to tell us now what bird this is. Please do.
Is it an ornithologist? Is a
what?
Bird person.
Yeah, an ornithologist, yeah.
So if we have any ornithologists watching this channel.
Mm-hmm. Tell us what's the name of the bird.
They'd probably be able to tell you the name from the bird from the image that you use.
I'll have a look. I don't think they will because it's a tattoo.
It gives you an idea.
I mean, I'm not using the image, I'm just doing it all freehand. Help me out.
Were you inspired by a bird that you saw?
Yeah.
This morning.
Yeah. Driving
to work. I just thought, oh yeah, we do a bird. There is actually a reason for this. I want to get a bird tattoo. My late granddad absolutely loved birds. So I want to have a bird tattoo. So I was looking at bird tattoos and I thought, stop the tattoo, let's do a nail with them on. The tattoo will definitely be more painful. Be worth it then. And I don't really know what type of bird I would get tattooed either, to be honest.
going to bring his chest out a little bit more. That's it. I'm literally just adding little bits of detail now. Tiny, tiny strokes. It's starting to take shape. Right, we've got a beak, we need a beak. And I'm going to highlight with a little bit of white as well. Just going to do his little feet so you can see why I did a shimmery glittery background. I think it really does bring out the colours of the nail art. That little birdie is so cute. What I'm going to do is seal this in now. I am going to do that with the Urban Graffiti top coat. What I'm going to do now is just add a little bit of bling. We've got these stones that I really like. They kind of change colour and I think they'll go really well with the colours that we've decided to use today. I'm going to put those on with acrylic. I'm going to finish this nail by putting some of the lemon cuticle oil on. And there we have it, a little birdie. Bird in flight.
Afternoon delight.
There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed that video of my birdie. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and all the products I've used today will be listed below as always, and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye. I had a whole conversation with myself. Obviously I thought you were listening to me.